Saturday morning. So thank God for that. We'll read a pair a scripture to you tonight. I had a different one laid on my heart, and God just would not let me settle on it. And he gave me this scripture. If you would, stand with me for the reading of God. And it's John chapter 8. I'm going to read verses 34 through 36. It says, Jesus answered them, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever committeth sin is the servant of sin. And the servant abideth not in the house forever, but the Son abideth forever." Verse 36 says, "If the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed." So if you're here tonight and you're bound and you're going through so many different problems and you see all these people getting a blessing and you're like, man, I wish I could get that. Hold to these scriptures. These scriptures do not lie. Jesus said, you know, whenever you call upon him, that he will make you free. But you have to turn from all those things. God don't set you free just to turn around and go back to him. That's where your strongholds come in. That's the reason why you can't lift your hands and worship and all these things. And tonight, I can say with all honesty that I'm free. Amen. I love that song, "Free to Worship." Free to lift up holy hands and glorify his name. Would y'all pray with me tonight? Lord, I thank you, God, for the opportunity, God, to be in this place. Thank you, Lord, for the opportunity, Lord, to be here, God, and to praise you, to worship you, to lift your name up. God, if there's any strongholds and bondages that are here tonight, God, I pray that you would break them. And God, that you would speak life into every single situation, God. You know the things that bind us, God. You know the things that have us bound, but Lord, you are there to set us free from them. Lord, every disappointment, God, every hurt, God, every circumstance, every temptation, every trial, Lord, you are there. Lord, I pray that you would move, anoint the singing, God, anoint the preaching. God, may you be glorified tonight. Holy Spirit, move in this service, Lord. We worship you. We thank you, Jesus. Come and expecting, God. Lord, I praise you for it. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, amen.
I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. For I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And I don't know what you came to do, but I came to clap my hands. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to clap my hands. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to clap my hands. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And I don't know what you came to do, but I came to shout for joy. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to shout for joy. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to shout for joy. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to shout for for joy. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to shout for joy. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to shout for joy. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I just came from a turned on church, and they were praising the Lord. I just came from a turned on church, and they were praising the Lord. Oh, I just came from a turned on church, and they were praising the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to shout for joy. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to shout for joy. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to shout for joy. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. But I just came from a turned on church, and they were praising the Lord. I just came from a turned on church, and they were praising the Lord. Oh, I just came from a turned on church, and they were praising the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Oh, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Is that what you've come to do? Have you come to lift his name on high and sing his praises? He surely has been good to us. And no matter the situations in our life, we have reason to give him praise and give him thanks. He really has, truly has been good to us.
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. Yeah, I said, Lord, 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 you've really been good to me.
Well, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. You have done what this world could not do.
Well, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me.
Well, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me.
Well, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. You have done what this world could not do. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. No, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. No, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. And the world, no, the world can't take it away.
Oh, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. Yeah, I said, Lord, 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 you've really been good to me.
Well, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. Yeah, You have done what this world could not do. You have done what this world could not do. You have done what this world could not do. You have done what this world could not do. And the world, another world can't take it away.
Oh, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. I said, Lord, 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 you've really been good to me.
Well, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. Yes, you have done what this world could not do.
Oh, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. Oh, I said, Lord, 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 you've really been good to me.
I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. And you have done what this world could not do.
Oh, you have saved my soul from a burning hell.
You have saved my soul from a burning hell. You have saved my soul from a burning hell. And the world, another world can't take it away.
Oh, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. Oh, I said, Lord, 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 you've really been good to me.
Well, I said,
Lord, 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 you've really been good to me. Yes, you have done what this world could not do. You have done what this world could not do. Well, you have done what this world could not do. Oh, you have done what this world could not do. And the world, another world can't take it away. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. Well, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. Oh, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. And the world, another world can't take it away.
Oh, I said,
Lord, 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 you really been good to me. I said, Lord, 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 you really been good to me.
Well, I said,
Lord, 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 you really been good to me. And you have done what this world could not do.
The world can't satisfy our souls. Only Jesus can do that. Hallelujah. He's the only one that saves. He's the only one that delivers. Hallelujah. He is the one and only. This joy that I have, the world did not give it to me. And the world can't take it away. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. For all that he has done.
Slow to anger, name is great and your heart is high. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to fight. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship your holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship your holy name. On that day when my strength is failing, the end draws near and my time has come, soon my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and there forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is high. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to fight. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Worship your holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship your holy name. I worship your holy name. I worship your holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship your holy name. I worship your holy. I worship your holy name.
Lord, would you lift your hands across this place and let's do that tonight. Father, we love you. Lord, we worship you tonight. Thank you, Lord, for all the reasons you've given us, Lord, to lift up the name of Jesus. God, on this Sunday night, thank you for the liberty I feel. Thank you, Lord, for the freedom of the Spirit of the Lord, Lord, that's in this place tonight. God, in all that we do, let it be pleasing unto you. Lord, we love you. We thank you. We worship you. We magnify you and lift up the name of Jesus. And help us in the remainder of this service, and we will forever be grateful for it. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Everybody said amen. Amen. Shake your neighbor by the hand. Amen. And bring them to the choir with you. Let's sing one out of that Redback book tonight. It's going to be a good night in the house of the Lord. Amen. They keep moving. We'll keep waiting. Amen. Hallelujah. Waiting on a few more of you. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. She'll play it again. We'll play it one more time just in case somebody wants to come. Hallelujah. There we go. All right. Who's next? I put brand new hymnals up here last week to make sure there was enough of them for you. Every seat has a hymnal now. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Here's the test. If they want to hear Sister Wendy play it again, they'll come now. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Let me just share a little bit about this song we're going to sing tonight. It's nothing new. It's page number 130 in your red back book. And I had Pastor Ricky call Christy all the way in New York City. She's gone. I got the service outlines. I had them before she left. I looked at Sunday nights last night, and it said for choir, pastor to decide. And I went, well, I don't know why I'm deciding. I knew last Sunday night you were out. And so I thought, well, did Brother Roger not give her a song for Sunday night? Did he tell me he wasn't going to be here and I forgot? Or did Christy mess it all up? And so I told Pastor, I said, I know she's in New York City, but I got to know. Call her. Well, I don't know if I need to reprint these. And she said, no, Brother Roger didn't give her a song for Sunday night, just for Sunday morning. And Christy's gone this weekend. And so earlier today, Titus said, what are we singing tonight? I said, I don't know. I said, it says pastor to decide. He says, well, I can decide for you. I said, oh, so you're going to tell me what song I'm going to sing that Brother Roger's going to lead. He says, yes. I said, okay, what would you like? And he said, page number 130, I never shall forget the day. I said, okay, I will try. So I called Brother Rogers. He come in. He had his book in his hand. I said, do you have a choir song for tonight? He says, page 130. I said, well, did you pick that or did somebody? He says, no, I thought about it coming to church tonight. Once again, a confirmation that if we will be sensitive to the Spirit of God. Now, this is an old one. I like this one. They're going to do it in the key of F. That's my key. Amen. And I'm going to sing like it's the last time I'll ever get to sing it. And if I have me a good old spell, I'll compose myself later, maybe. And we are in a Pentecostal church. Amen. Are you glad Jesus washed your sins away? Amen. Let's sing it tonight.
Let me say this. I was a third of the way to church tonight. And I don't know why, but there's a deputy across the road, and it was in one of those places on the back road, Judy, where you can't have any other avenues. You got to turn around and go back. So I turned around and had to come into a Popka and get on the 451 to get to the 429. And I had already chosen a song. I told my wife what it was before I left home. She asked me. And on the way, after I got turned around by the deputy, instead of getting angry, this song just welled up in my heart.
Amen.
And I said, well, the one that I chose is not the right one, but this is. So God has a way. And I don't know about you, but I'm praying about this. I pray that those lights are on because they've got that rascal trapped. Amen. And I thought about that as I come to 429. You can look over and see the country roads, and it looked like all the side roads were blocked. So I don't know. They've got something big going on. It's not just an accident. But let's worship with this song tonight because God ordained it. I really believe that. And that's the way I want to sing songs. I want to sing God-ordained songs. And I never can forget the day that He saved me. I hope I never will. God bless us all as we sing.
My soul.
Oh, sinner, come to Jesus now. At his dear feet, just humbly bow. Confess to him your every sin. He'll save and cleanse you, give you peace and joy within. I never second verse one more time. Now I can feel him by my side, my feeble state. He comes to God when trials come. He comforts me through faith in him. Oh, and I have the victory. I never
sing another one. 393. Come on, Brother Roger. Key of C. 393, just another one of my favorites. Amen. When we all get to heaven. Anybody out there going to heaven tonight? Amen. Let's sing it.
Yeah. looking forward to going to heaven. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't forget that tonight, right after the evening service, there is an informational meeting for U-Turn students and a parent or guardian. So if you are a U-Turn student, please stay. If you are a parent or guardian of a U-Turn student, please stay and have some information we need to share with you tonight. Don't forget about prayer, fasting and prayer this week, tomorrow night, 7 o'clock. The doors will be open by 6:30 every night. And then at 7 o'clock, we will have some scripture and Bible reading at 7, and then there'll be instructions on how we will move through that hour of prayer Monday night, Tuesday night, Thursday night, Friday night, and then Saturday at 5 o'clock. So grab your bulletin. All of that's in there where you'll know where to be. And then so informational meeting tonight, prayer services this week. Wednesday night will be a regular service, Wednesday night meals and Wednesday night clubs and classes and main building. Wednesday night's a regular service, and then prayer Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then there's other activities Saturday after prayer time. Also, next Sunday is a regular schedule. We're back. Hallelujah. The holidays are over with. Amen. We're back to regular schedule, and I'm thankful for that tonight. The ushers will get ready to wait upon you tonight, give you an opportunity to give of your tithe, of your offerings, our gifts unto the Lord. We need your commitment, faithfulness. God loves a cheerful giver. All those things that we have heard, and tonight's no different. And let's continue to have a strong month as we're just believing the Lord to answer all of our requests, financially, spiritually, numerically. We know that God's able, and I want to say thank you for your giving as unto the Lord. Let us pray tonight. Father, we love you tonight. Thank you for the Spirit of God that we have already been able to fill in this place. Thank you for the anointing, Lord. Thank you for the liberty. Thank you for the privilege we have now to worship you in our giving. God, Lord, if giving of an offering, giving of our tithe kills our spirit, God, then it was the wrong spirit to begin with. And tonight, God, I am given as a cheerful giver unto the work of the Lord. Bless the gift. Multiply it. Lord, bless the families that give tonight. Bless their homes, and we will forever be thankful for it. In the wonderful name of Christ, we pray. And everybody said amen. And amen. God bless you as you give tonight.
And everybody will be happy over there. What a day of rejoicing that will be. Hallelujah. Need to make just one real quick announcement. Saturday we are having prime timers. We usually have it at 5 o'clock, but instead we're doing it at 6 o'clock. 5 o'clock you need to be here for our prayer and fasting here at 7 o'clock. That's for 5 o'clock. We need you, prime timers. This will be part of prime timers. Well, prayer, and then we eat. We usually do eat in a movie or a fellowship or something. We're doing the prayer, and then we're doing eating, so you won't have to be here so long, so you can get home and get ready for church on Sunday. So what we're doing potluck. A lot of us are fasting and fasting different things, so just bring whatever you can eat, bring it that day. Some of you may be fasting meat, some of you may be fasting whatever you're doing, just bring something you can eat that way. That way, whatever fast you're on, we'll be able to eat. So that will be Saturday night at 5 o'clock prayer, 6 o'clock time of fellowship in the fellowship hall, okay? Amen. We have our special music tonight. Sister Rebecca is going to come sing for us, followed by our youth choir. So let's give Sister Rebecca and the choir a hand as they come.
Before Sister Wendy starts, I had a different song I'd picked out because it's prayer and fasting, and thought I'd sing Power in Prayer. You know, I had it all picked out and taught Sister Wendy about it. And then this morning, as we were talking about the need for revival, we've sang the song over and over here, Send the Rain, Send the Fire. And sometimes I feel like we've sang it so much. And many times as we've sung it, I said, Lord, let me sing that as if that's my prayer. Lord, I'm tired of the same old thing. Lord, I'm ready for revival. But God started really convicting me today as I was kind of going over the words in my head. And said, Lord, am I really ready? There's a line there that says, I'm ready to walk through the door. Lord, am I really ready to walk through the door? And for me, I think that this time of prayer and fasting this week is going to be, I want to let God deal with any part of me that may hinder his move of his spirit in my life and in this church. Pastor sobered me, I guess, when he said today that, you know, the prayer is, Lord, if it's me, move me. And I'm sitting back there going, Lord, I don't want to be moved. I love my church, so you're going to have to change me if it's me. But that I really want to see God move. And there are some days I fall short of being ready for revival. So tonight, I want this to be my prayer for revival. God has done great things in my life, but sometimes I get so caught up in my own battle in my mind that I forget that I'm part of a church body that God needs to move in, that you face a challenge. And tonight, I know we need revival. So I pray God will send the rain tonight. Just the same old thing of tradition wearing your name. I'm tired of a man-made worship hour. I'm tired. And I'm tired of a song without praise where worship just seems out of place. I'm tired of formality. Lord, I'm tired. Send the rain. Send the fire. Send the wind. Send the Holy Ghost and just the same old thing of tradition wearing your name. I'm tired of a man-made worship hour. I'm tired. And I'm tired of a song without praise where worshiping sits out of place. I'm tired of formalities. Lord, I'm tired. So send the rain, send the fire. To walk through the door, we're ready, Lord. Oh, let it pour. We're ready,
And we're ready to let you be God. We're ready to let you have your way. We're ready, Lord, so fill us up. Send it now, we pray. Send the rain, send the fire, send the wind, send the Holy Ghost and power. Send the rain, send the fire, send the wind, send the Holy Ghost and power. Send the rain. We're ready for revival, Lord. We're ready to walk through the door. We're ready, Lord. Oh, let it pour. We're ready. And we're ready to let you be God. We're ready to let you have your way. We're ready, Lord. Oh, fill us up and send it now, we pray. Send the rain, send the fire, send your wind, send the Holy Ghost and power. Send the rain, send the fire, send the wind, send the Holy Ghost and power. Send the rain, send the fire, Lord, send the wind, send the Holy Ghost and power. Send the
touching me Friday and Saturday, and I'm thankful for what he's going to do tonight.
You thought I was worth saving, so you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping, so you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for, so you sacrificed your life, so I could be free, so I could be whole.
give you glory.
We're saving, so you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping, so you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for, so you sacrificed your life, so I could be free,
so I could be whole. I'll give you glory.
Because I am free, because I am whole, and I will tell everyone I know.
You thought I was worth saving, so you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping, so you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for, so you sacrificed your life.
Each day is just the same.
what the Lord has done. Will he heal my body? He touched my mind. Please save me. It was just in time.
Worth saving, so you
came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping, so you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for, so you sacrificed your life so I could be free,
so I could be whole. So you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping.
Worth keeping.
So you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for. So you sacrificed your life. So I could be free. So I could be whole. So I could tell everyone I love.
Hallelujah.
I'll give you glory, because I am free, because I am whole, and I will tell everyone I love. Hallelujah, glory to the God who changed my life, and I will praise you, I'll worship you, I'll give you glory.
Before you go down, I'm going to preach. Before you go down, before you leave this atmosphere, would you turn off the mics, lift up your hands, and would you thank the Lord for saving you tonight? Amen. Father, we love you tonight. God, and on this platform, Lord, they've sung praises unto you. Lord, they have shared their song out of their heart tonight. Lord, and I don't want one of them, God, to not have an opportunity, Lord, to lift up holy hands and to give praise and honor and glory unto the one who gave them everything. Lord, I pray tonight, Lord, that you'll prick their hearts. I pray tonight, God, that you will minister to them. I pray tonight, Lord, that they will be sensitive to the leading of the Spirit of God. Lord, if they need to call upon you, let them call upon you right now. Lord, if they need to have a broken heart, let them have that broken heart right now. Lord, if they need to walk through a door, let them walk through that door right now. Lord, if they need to turn everything over to a God who cares, let it be right now. Let it be right now. Let it be right now, Lord. For Lord, it would all be in vain if it wasn't for your blood. It would all be in vain if it wasn't for your anointing, your power, and your mercy. Lead them and guide them and direct them, God. Lord, it will forever be thankful for it. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And this congregation said, amen. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise tonight. If you can go down, you can go down. If you're done, if you don't need to pray, if you don't need to testify, if you don't need to worship, here you go. Anybody need to testify? Hallelujah. Titus, testify.
I'm thankful for what God's done in my life, for blessing me, for sanctifying me, and He's going to fill me with that Holy Ghost.
Amen.
I'm thankful for the anointing of the Lord. I'm thankful for what God's doing in our youth group, in our youth choir, in our church. And I, like Ryan said this morning, I'm ready for revival.
Amen.
God, I want the Holy Ghost to pour down. God, I want the neighbors to call the police department because they see fire on top of Ocoee. Ocoee Church of God has fire on top of it, God. God, I just want the Holy Ghost to pour down.
Hallelujah. Amen. My baby preached Saturday morning. You didn't watch her on Facebook, you can. She's on Sister Holly's page. Testify, Cherry. Tell a little bit about what you preached. Don't preach. Well, the Lord leads you. You can preach.
I'm thankful for everything that He's done for us. And I preached a little bit about running the race and how we have to make it to the finish line.
Oh, yes.
And I was thinking before we sung this song today, and I've just been thinking about it. When we get to heaven, we're going to be able to sing that song to Jesus. You thought that was worth saving. We're going to be able to sing it to His face. So hallelujah. Glory to the God who changed my life. And I'm looking forward to that day. I'm ready. I'm ready to go to heaven. I'm thankful for what He's doing in our youth group. I've prayed for fire. Ryan even said the other day, I feel like we're in a spiritual coma. We're not dead, but we need to be 1, 2, 3 cleared. And we need to be put back to life. And I'm thankful for the fire that's burning. In the van going up to Baldwin, there was just an expectation, and the Lord did meet us. And then He's met us here. And I preach to them all the time at choir practice. And they're starting to listen to me, I think. And I'm thankful for that. And I'm just thankful for everything that He's doing. And pray for us. Keep us in your prayers. I want to see us on fire, really on fire.
Amen. Amen. Garrett, testify.
I'm thankful for the Lord touching us at Baldwin. It really helped me. He touched us in the van. I'm thankful for that. Thankful for Him touching my family, for Him bringing us all closer. I'm done.
Where's your microphone? Testify, Natalie. You can sing, you can testify. Just love on Jesus.
On the way to Baldwin, we was all in the van and we was talking about how we wanted to be a light for Jesus, how we wanted the other church to look at us and say, I want to be like them. And we wanted the power of God to fall. And the ride in the van really helped me. And I'm thankful for what He's doing.
Amen. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'll let y'all testify. Anybody just got a testimony? You got to get out right now. All right. Ryan, play me some of that. Look what the Lord has done as they find their way to their seat. Stand with me for the reading of God's word. Hallelujah. Testify. Stay right there. Testify real quick, Hannah.
I want to thank the Lord for what He's doing in our youth group. Before this weekend, I was praying to God, Lord, let Your fire fall on this weekend in Baldwin and Ocoee, God. Lord, we want Your fire to fall on this youth group. We want to be set on fire for You. Our youth group wants to have revival, and I believe the Lord will give it to us if we seek it. And I want to thank Him for what He's done this weekend in my life and in all the lives of our youth groups.
Amen. Students. Hallelujah. Testify one more time before I preach. He testified this morning. Let's hear Him one more time. Listen to Him. Go to Psalms 85 for me.
Well, once again, I thank the Lord for what He's given me in this church. He's blessed us with a wonderful group of people, of kids, and just church in general. And like I said this morning, I'm looking for revival. I've been praying for it. A lot of, if not all of our youth students have been praying the same prayer I have. And I'm just waiting for the fire to just fall on this church. And man, I can't wait for that moment.
Amen.
I'm just praying and looking for it. And I'm Amen. Just so glad to see the lives changed as just in the past few months. And I just thank God for what he's doing and what he will do in this church.
Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Do you see him growing up right before your eyes? Right before our eyes. What these young people get in these altars will carry them for the rest of their life. Amen. Not that's the only touch that they need, but it will be a foundation for them. That when all hell assails them, they know there is a rock that they can cry out to. Amen? Amen. Appreciate Pastor Dustin and Sister Holly and their ministry. Psalms chapter 85, let me just read it. I'm going to preach a few moments. Let me just get a little bit of the preach out of me, okay? It's been a couple services. And if you'll hang in with me for a few moments, and then we'll end. I don't know how we'll end it yet. I'm praying while I preach, the Lord will help me. And we'll find us a landing ground. Psalms 85, verse number 6, while you're reading that, let me just say, in case I don't say it later, visitors, we've got visitors tonight, and we're just delighted that you're here. Come back and be with us. We love you in Jesus, and we don't apologize for our worship. And if they don't worship like this or Pentecostal in your church, you should consider coming being with us all the time. Amen. I'm going to get in trouble tonight. Hallelujah. Psalms 85 and verse number 6. Will thou not revive us again, that thy people may rejoice in thee? Show us thy mercy, O God, and grant us thy salvation. Show us thy mercy, O Lord, and grant us thy salvation. I'll start this. I don't plan on preaching it next week. I'm going a total different direction next Sunday unless God changes my mind. But just for a few moments tonight, I want to preach to us on this thought, revival or ruin. See, I've heard that before. You have, because I told you this morning, in the last 5 years, I have preached 4 times out of this text specifically. And I have actually used this title, and I've said, God, as my heart has been turned over this week, God, I want to know without a doubt that there is still revival available for your people in the year of 2017. Father, we love you tonight. Lord, I cannot do anything without your anointing. I cannot, Lord, make it better. Lord, all I will do is make it worse. But Lord, if you will anoint me for a few moments in time, Lord, that I can begin to deliver some of the things that are birthed in my heart, Lord, that are before me on this sacred desk. Lord, if I can just maybe put a period or even an exclamation point after the songs tonight, Lord, it will be done to give you praise, you honor, and you glory. Lord, we live in a day where we truly need revival, but Lord, I want to make sure we know what revival really means. Lord, I want to make sure that we're ready for revival. Lord, I want to make sure that you can revive me. Lord, that I can be used for the kingdom of God. Help us, guide us, and direct us, and we will forever be grateful for it. In the name of Jesus we pray, and everybody said amen. And amen and amen. You may be seated tonight just for a few moments. And again, I'm aware of the time. Revival or ruin. And I've talked about this thought before, about the need for revival. And I hear that word revival. We hear it at the state level. We hear it at the local level. We hear it in our church level about we need revival. Revival is a much talked about subject in our time. And I wonder how much is truly being done for revival. I wonder how much preparation, how much a consideration is being made in our life for a move of God. Almost everyone uses the word revival. Almost everyone in every Christian movement understands that we are in a time where we need a spiritual awakening. Papa Hanks has preached about it. Others have preached about it. Our state office is trying to help us understand the importance of finishing the great commitment, it seems, on every hand, on every side. There is this thought about an awakening, a rebirth, a revival in the hearts and the lives of the men and women of God. Sad to say, maybe some of our politicians are even realizing that there needs to be a change or an awakening, but I'm not sure they understand what they say when they say things like, we need a spiritual renewal or spiritual revival. Oh God, I would love for the Holy Ghost of God to get a hold of a few of them, amen. I would love for the Holy Ghost of God to shake a few of them all the way through from salvation to sanctification to the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And I don't want to be a part of a clique or part of a group that uses the word revival loosely. I don't want to be a part of a church that says, oh, we need revival, or we're having revival, or we want revival. No, I don't want to be ones that use my words only, but I want revival to be born in my heart first of all, and then manifested around my life and in my family and in my home. I say, God, let us realize tonight what revival truly is. You hear words like prayer conferences and spiritual awakenings, special evangelistic campaigns, all those things are done in an effort to revive the church. But if you attend those services, they are usually no more or no different than a regular ordinary service. Some places I have been to, some places I may have watched, some places I may have heard about, I wouldn't want to be there every Sunday. Why? Because, honey, it's twice dead and plucked up by the root already. Amen. I don't want that for my life. I want to be in a relationship with a God that touches me from the top of my head to the soles of my feet. Revival. Revival. It seems that the times that we live, the anti-God forces are rampant. We're conscious of our spiritual situation in our own nation. What used to be called wrong is now called right. What used to be called black is now called white. What used to be okay to do is now a sin to do. I say, God, if there's ever a time that the true church of the living God needs revival, it is tonight. And I don't want to preach all of it to you. I just want to help you understand when these kids say, we want revival, when they say, we want a fire, when you as adults say, I want God to move, I want you to understand what you are saying. Teenagers, if you have never experienced a revival in your life, let me help you understand tonight that word revival is possibly one of the most misused and the most abused terms in churches just like ours. There are multiplied upon multiplied advertisements about revival on billboards and newspapers and websites and social media. But when you go to those services, it is a pathetic reasoning for the move of God, or for what we would call a revival, regardless of how lifeless and how dead some of our meetings are. We continue to call them revival. Honey, that's not revival. That's going through motions. That's not revival. That's just going through a formality and a routine and a form. And Pastor Rebecca told us tonight, we don't need to be in a form. I'm tired of the same old thing. I'm tired of the man-made worship. I'm ready for revival. So what is revival? What is revival? Revival or an evangelistic campaign are two different things. What we're praying for in our church right now is revival. Revival is God's people getting thoroughly right with God. God's people getting thoroughly right with God. It is an awakening or a returning unto God. Revival. I don't get into all the parts of speeches and things of that nature. English wasn't my favorite, still not my favorite. Revive, to live again, meaning you once were alive, but something has happened and now you are dead or you are in a comatose state. I say, God, revival is God's people. That's us. That's the ones that lift up our hands and say we're saved and on our way to heaven. It is God's people getting thoroughly right with God. Not just 99 and a fourth. Not just 99.9, but Sister Leslie, his spirit getting all the way in and pushing out the things that he's not happy with. Well, Pastor, is there anything in my life that God's not happy with? That's only between you and God. But I'll tell you, none of us are perfect. None of us have been glorified. When I pinch you, you still hurt. So I would surmise and be able to say tonight that all of us have a little bit of growing up we can do. Can somebody say amen? Amen. revive us. Revive us. It's not an evangelistic campaign. It's a revival. It starts with those that are inside these four walls crying out to a holy God to revive us or to once again bring us back to life. It is a spiritual renewal, a renewal of faith, a renewal of power, a renewal of testimony. It is a renewal of a witness for Christ. There are those who are dead in trespasses, and there are those that are still in a life of sin. They can't be revived, for they've never known life the first time. What they need is an evangelistic campaign. What they need is for somebody who is alive and revived to go out to them and tell them what Jesus has done for them, and they can then be born into the kingdom of God. Problem is, we as a church are not revived enough to share our message outside these four walls. Revive us. Lord, there are times for evangelistic campaigns. That brings church growth. That brings more discipleship. That brings babes in Christ. Lord, we need that. But before we will ever be able to do that effectively, we need the saints of God to one more time be revived. Because I'm going to tell you, I can't do it by myself. You can't do it by yourself. But with you, working with you, working with you, and working with each other, we collectively will be an army of the Most High that has been anointed and called for a season and a time like this. And because of God's anointing, we will be able to go out and some of the things that these young people are praying for and asking for and believing for will come to pass. And I'm just of this thought tonight. My prayer is, God, if everybody gets on board, praise the Lord. But God, if there's one or two or three that want to get stuck in the mud, Lord, don't let us stop for them. We'll love them. We'll pray for them. We'll hope they'll catch on with us. But God, continue to usher in your power and usher in your presence and move across this place and let us have true revival. Revival. Scripture says, Romans chapter 14, for to this end Christ both dead and rose and revived the cold and the indifferent and the lukewarm church member who has lost the freshness of his experience can be revived because of the power of God. Reminded, revival begins with the Christian. Later I will preach possibly that revival ends with salvation of the lost. When we get revived, there will be new birth into the kingdom of God. When we get revived, there will be a desire for discipleship and growth and some steadfastness. But if we never get revived, we are really doing an injustice to those sinners that come into eyesight of our four walls, because we are not spiritually ready to become the disciple to them that they need to help them. I say, God, revive. I'm hurrying. Come on, Sister Wendy. Our prime need in the church is revival. Then all of our church programs will be brought into proper focus. Only revival can change or to delay or offset the judgment and the wrath of God. Once the people of God are revived, that evangelistic component, that evangelism will be inevitable. In evangelistic campaign, sinners are begged and persuaded to come forward. But in revivals, if we truly have revival, that sinner will come and say, "What must I do to be saved?" Why? Because the anointing and the power and the life and the Spirit of God is so evident in a church that has been revived. It won't be, "Well, you need to get saved." It will be that sinner saying, "Dear Lord, have mercy. What must I do to be saved?" I don't want to almost persuade them. I want to bring them all the way in. Can somebody say amen? In evangelistic campaigns, the message is directed to sinners. But in a time of revival, messages are directed to Christians. In evangelistic campaigns, there must be an evangelist, sometimes advertisement, organization, and a place to have an evangelistic campaign. But revivals can result without the aid of any of those. You don't have to announce revival. You just got to make yourself available, get up on the altar of God, and say, Lord, I give myself to you. And when the fire of God falls, you won't have to tell anybody. We'll see it. We'll realize you look different, talk different, act different, smell different, and those that are around you will see the same, and folks will come to see you burn under the anointing of the power of God. There have been those that unfortunately have grew up in this, that we have, spiritually speaking, taken a big needle and injected into them a form of worship. And they come in and we go through the routines and we leave. And I'm thankful for order and organization and structure. It all has its place. This can't be a free-for-all. But it must be only second to the power and the anointing of a living God. I said, God, give us revival. In days that we live in, religion has been so popularized, and people from all stations of life give words like, we are Christian, or I am Christian, or I believe anybody can go to heaven, or there are many ways to heaven, and we're all, I've heard it all. Can I tell you, there is still but one way to heaven, that is through the blood of His Son, Jesus Christ, and when that blood comes in contact with your life, it will make a change. And if you have lost your excitement, if you have lost your effectiveness, if you have lost your joy, could I offer to you that you one more time need to find yourself to an altar of prayer, and your prayer doesn't need to be one of these now I lay me down to sleep kind of prayers, but your prayer needs to be with hands extended and voice toward heaven. Oh God, would you revive me again? Stand with me. There are many. Many in Christian movements just like ours that will go through a season of time, go through a series of meetings, things of that nature, and they will say, wow, we've had good church. What does that mean? I've been guilty of it. Was posted today on Facebook, we had good church. What does that mean? Depends on where you're coming from. If you like emotions, maybe it was good. If you're ready for a sinner to be saved, we might have fell short this morning. If you're ready for somebody to be sanctified and filled with the Holy, we might have fell short this morning. Oh, but if you're desiring for a rebirth of the power and the presence of God, I believe we got off to a good start. Amen? And I say, Lord, don't let us stop on a Sunday morning. Don't let us stop on a Sunday night. Don't let it start just with the young people or the old people or the middle-aged people. But God, would you just sweep across this place and would you touch every one of us? Amen. Now here's the challenge, especially in, just play, honey, you're doing a good job. Especially in Okoye. Here's what happened. Some of us have been here so long. Somebody asked me the other day, how long you been in Okoye? I said, well, how do you want to look at it? You want to look at how long I've been there as pastor? That's 8+ years. Do you want to look at how long I've been in Okoye? That's been since 2002. Any way you look at it, I've been here a long time. He said, it was the 2002 time I was thinking. I said, yeah, I'm old. I've been there forever. But I don't want to be here forever and it be the same old stuff every week. I get bored way too easily. I find things to do to keep me out of trouble. Amen. And spiritually speaking, I said, God, I love what we have. And the problem with some of us is we look at this crowd tonight, the crowd this morning, and we say, well, we'll let somebody else go push in tonight. I'll stay back here and I'll let them. I don't need you to do that tonight. I need you to push in for yourself tonight. Okay? I need you to push in for yourself tonight. There's not a soul in this building that's got everything together tonight. There ain't a soul in this building that everybody you know is saved tonight. There ain't a soul in this building that couldn't use a fresh top off of the power of God tonight. So don't say, well, I'll let them go and pray. No, if you do, you're missing your opportunity to be revived by the Spirit of God. So here's how we're going to do it. Got to do it in order. We got to do it in right fashion. Sister Wendy's going to sing. And I'm going to start with the young people first, because they sometimes follow my instructions maybe better than some of the adults. Guys, get to this platform. Don't just pray a few little prayers. But like you were praying Friday night and Saturday morning, like y'all had prayer meeting in the van, I understand. Let's pray. Don't be afraid to of your neighbor hearing you pray. It'll be all right. If they don't like what you're saying, tell them ain't none of their business. You're talking to God and not them anyhow. Get it right with the Lord. And we'll let you guys move first and clear off some of these pews. And then some of us adults are going to find us a place to pray. And we're not going to just patty cake around. Nope. None of this mamby-pamby stuff tonight. God, you've touched us all day today. And I want to leave with a fresh touch of the Holy Ghost. Amen. All right, young people, I'm going to let you move first. Get to this platform quickly. Quickly. Move chairs, whatever you got to do. We'll put it back together later. Those folks that helped me do that. Use the pastor's chairs. Use the benches. I don't care. Use the chairs on the walls. Just find a place to pray. That gives us plenty of room now, adults. Pastor Dustin and his team will take care of praying with these folks. If you got a kid up here, you just got to come pray with, you come pray with them. But can I encourage you to pray for yourself first? We started prayer meeting at 5:30, 2 hours ago, praying with our families, did we not? Let's pray for ourselves tonight. Come and gather around these altars and let's cry out to God. God, we need revival. God, I need revival. Lord, I want you to show me your glory one more time. God, I want you to move in my heart and in my life one more time. God, I want to know without a doubt that I'm not going through a routine or a rut, but God, I'm being moved upon by the power and the anointing of God. Lord, I pray tonight as we fill these altars and strip these pews up, Lord, that your anointing and your power will go with us. And Lord, that your Spirit will revive us. Lord, that your anointing will be alive. Lord, that our life will be infiltrated, not by the world, not by the enemy, but Lord, moved upon by the power and the anointing of a holy God. Use us tonight, I pray, oh God. Use us tonight, I pray, oh God. Use us tonight, I pray. Come on, church. Call out to him, church. Call out to him, church. Oh, God, I need you. God, I need you. Lord, I need you. Revive me, oh, God. Thank you.
someone who may have failed to see the way. I too was once so lost, but I found my way to God. Still, it's my desire to live for Him. If you could see
Sister Debbie, I'm sending these kids to pray for you. Just asking God for a touch in your life. If you're close to Sister Debbie, lift your hand. Put it that way. Ask God to move. Father, right now you're able. In the name of the name that is above all names, Lord, we call upon you tonight. Lord, we're coming to you with childlike faith. We're asking God for a move of God. Lord, we pray for individuals in this place this morning. Lord, tonight we're praying for Sister Debbie. God, that you'll move. God, touch Sister Jane. Touch the Maynards tonight. Be with Mary Stevens and Ann Davis tonight. Lord, touch Sister Sasser and touch Brother Clifton. Lord, just move across this place. Lord, and let your name be relevant. Let your name be everything. Let your name be a strength, God, that comes only from you. Help us tonight, I pray. Lead us and guide us and direct us, God. Lord, and we will forever be grateful for it tonight. Lord, we will forever be thankful for the experience we've had with you in this place tonight. Help us, lead us, guide us, and direct us, Lord, and we will forever be grateful for all that you've done, all that you are doing, and all that you are going to do. Lord, in this church, Lord, my desire is that we will be a church that's on fire. We will be a church that is alive. Lord, in order to do that, Lord, I've got to get things where I need to be. Lord, I pray you'll continue to deal with me. Wake me up in that midnight hour. Lord, burn the things of the world out of my life. Let me be focused. Let me be strategic. Let me be intentional, God. Lord, and every time I come to this pulpit, let it be to lift up the name of Jesus. Lord, and we will forever give you praise, honor, and glory for it. In the name of the Most Holy One, we pray. And everybody said, amen. I'm ready for church now. What a great day it has been in the Lord's house. Tomorrow night, 7 o'clock, right here. Won't be church. It's going to be prayer. There'll be some specific things that we will do. Some instructions that you will get at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. Church, Monday night, Tuesday night. Church, Wednesday night. So, I want to see you. If you want revival, unless it's just something you can't get out of, you'll be here. I didn't just put this on us tonight for tomorrow night. We've known for weeks. I'm ready. I'm ready. Can you stand with me? Whew. Hallelujah. We're going to move quickly to a youth meeting right after this, so fellowship fast. Amen. And we'll do it right over here on this side. Father, we love you tonight. God, there's really no way to dismiss out of this. We're just thankful for your presence. We're thankful that you are alive and you are well. And Father, we pray that you'll touch every need, that you'll go with us. Bring us back at the next appointed time. Lord, and let us, Lord, be able to say that we have been revived by the Spirit of God. Help us in all that we do tonight and tomorrow, and we'll forever be grateful for it. And everybody said amen and amen.